Welcome back. So in today's session, in this session, we'll see the counters. One of the other applications of flip-flop is in counters. So in the previous class, we saw the application of flip-flop as a register which stores information, and also we exclusively saw one of the application of flip-flop to be in the shift register, wherein we saw the serial in, serial out, and finally we went up with seeing what is this universal shift register. Okay. So now we'll see the counters. Okay. So a counter is basically a register that goes through a prescribed sequence of states upon the application of input pulses. Okay. Input pulses are usually clock pulses. Example, an n-bit binary counter count in binary from 0 to 2 power of n minus 1. Okay. So this is what we have. So it will go through some specific predefined sequence of states. Okay. So there are two classifications in this counters. One is the ripple counter, or in other words, you call this as something like asynchronous counter. Okay. So ripple counter or asynchronous counter. Asynchronous counters. This is what you have. Okay. So ripple counters are also called as asynchronous counters. Flip-flop output transition serves as the pulse to trigger the other flip-flops. Okay, so here we do something called the cascading, similar to the shift registers, but not exactly. We'll see what exactly we will do here. Okay, so whereas in synchronous counter, flip-flop receives the same common clock. So in synchronous counter, or if I design a counter, and if that counter is a synchronous counter, all the flip-flops in the counter receive the same common clock as the pulse. Is it clear? They all receive the same common clock as the pulse here. Whereas in ripple counters, only one flip-flop will receive the main clock, and the next subsequent flip-flops will be using the outputs of the previous. So that's why the flip-flop output transition serves as the pulse to trigger the other flip-flops. Okay, this is the difference between a ripple counters and asynchronous counters. Anyhow, we'll try to see now. Okay, once again, definition of a counter. A counter is basically a register, which is a group of flip-flop, that goes through a prescribed sequence of states upon the application of input pulses. And this input pulses are usually the clock pulses. Okay. So if I have a 5-bit, 3-bit binary counter, means it will go from 0 to 7. Okay. So 2 power of n is 8. 8 minus 1 is 7. So 0 to 7 it will count. Okay. We can design up counting, down counting, up down counter and all. We'll try to see now. So very first, we'll take up what is this binary ripple counter or asynchronous counter. Okay, binary ripple or asynchronous counter. Okay, so this is what we have. For example, 3-bit. Okay, with 3-bit, I can have maximum 2 power of 3, that is 8 counts. Okay, with 3-bit, I can have 8 counts. Since I start from 0, okay, I'll go from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Okay, so I'll go from 0 to 7. Okay, and then again 0. 0 to 7, 0 to 7 it goes. Okay, so that's what. So 3-bit binary ripple counter. Okay, if it is an up counting, it will start from 0, increment. Up counting is increment, down counting is decrement kind of thing. If I am at 0, the next count will be 1, next 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7, and again it will be going from 0 to 1. To connect the output of one flip-flop to the C input is predominantly is my clock input. Okay, so this is what we try to do in the ripple counter or asynchronous counter. To the next higher order flip-flop. So one of the flip-flop will get the common main clock, and the next subsequent flip-flop's clock input will be the other flip-flop outputs. That's what this meaning. We need complementing flip-flops. Okay, that is toggling, I said, right? So we had used. So typically counter, especially the ripple counter, makes use of the concept called the toggling. And the toggling we can get using T flip-flop, or shorting my JK and making it one, or D flip-flops with complement output connected to the D input. Okay, so either we can use T flip flop, JK flip flop, or the D flip flop in this fashion. Okay. So we'll go with 4-bit binary ripple counter. 4-bit means I will have a count from 0. Okay, so I will have a count from 0 to 2 power of 4. How much is 2 power of 4? 16. 16 minus 1, that is 15. Okay. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So 0 in terms of binary using 4-bit is 0, 0, 0, 0. 15 in terms of binary is 1, 1, 1, 1. So this is the decimal equivalent of binary 0. This is the 15. So I will have something like this fashion, 0 to 15. Okay. How exactly we try to connect it now? Okay. So as I said, we are trying to use T flip flop here. 1, 1, 1, and 1. And make sure whenever it is a ripple counter or asynchronous counter, okay, if I am using the T flip-flop, make sure how many flip-flop you use, okay, all the flip-flops T input should be given to logic 1, or sometimes you call it as plus VCC also. Plus VCC is logic 1, ground is logic 0 we call. Okay, this is what we try to do now. Okay, instead of T flip-flop, if I make use of JK flip-flop, short JK of all the flip-flops and connect it to VCC. That is a common thing you do. Okay. And when I say 4-bit, okay, 1-bit, 1 flip-flop. So 4-bit, 4 flip-flop. If I want to design a n-bit binary ripple counter, I require n flip-flops. Okay, it's a straightforward. Okay. 4-bit means I require 4 flip-flops. 4 flip-flops I want to design a 4-bit binary ripple counter. Okay, this is one of the T flip-flop. This is the second T flip-flop. This is the fourth, third, and this is my fourth flip-flop. Okay, you can see that first flip-flop is getting the main clock, okay, count or clock, whatever. Clock or count, whatever you want, you can call it as. Is this clear? Then you can see output of the first acting as a clock input of the second. Okay. Output of the second flip-flop acting as a clock input of the third. Output of the third flip-flop, that is A2, acting as a clock input of this. This is how exactly the ripple counter does. Okay, only one flip-flop will get the main clock, okay, and the next subsequent will get the output from the previous. So it is something like a cascaded version, but here output is not given to the input, but it is given to the clock input. That is the difference between a shift register. And in shift register, output of one flip-flop is given as an input to the second, whereas in the binary ripple counter, output of the one of the stage will be acting as a clock input of the second stage. You can see that A0 is going here. This is not, this is the clock. A1 is glowing here. A1 is glowing here. A2 is going over here. This is what happens, right? Now we'll try to analyze. First, I will clear all the outputs of this flip-flop. This is 0. This is 0. This is 0. And this is 0. So I clear all the flip-flop by enabling this particular clear input by providing 0. Since there is a bubble at this reset input, so if I give 0, internally it becomes 1 and that will be enabled. So this clear input is common, yes? So by providing 0, I will clear all the things, okay? 0 is enabling the clear, 1 is disabling. After I clear the outputs, I make this clear input to be disabled by providing 1. If I provide 1, internally it becomes 0 for all these clear inputs, so it won't be clear. Okay. So next, it's all about the count now. Yes, you should be very careful what really happens now. Okay. So this is T is connected to 1, and we know that T flip-flop, okay, this is my clock or count. Whenever all these are positive edge triggered, okay, assuming, or since it is a bubble is there, it is negative edge triggered. Okay, so what I'll try to do, so instead of this I'll try to go with a negative edge triggered, since there is an inversion. Okay, this is a negative edge triggered T flip, all are. Okay, so we know that whenever the clock comes, if T is 1, my next state output will be the complement of its previous, right? This is what, when there is no clock, when clock is 0, that means no clock, that means other than negative edge, anything else is there, okay? Irrespective of my T, when clock is disabled, irrespective of my T, my output will be the previous. This is what I'm trying to have. That's it. Okay. So this is what I'm having. So initially, I had reset or cleared all the flip-flops output in this fashion. Okay. By enabling this, and later I disabled my clear. Now this, all the T4 flip-flops are now depending upon clock as well as the count now. Yes. Now you see, since output of the first triggers the clock, you should ensure that, okay, here flip-flop 1, okay, will be enabled based on this count. Flip-flop 2 will be enabled based on my A0. Until unless I get A0, flip-flop 2 won't be enabled. So flip-flop 3 will be enabled with respect to A1, and flip-flop 4 is enabled with respect to A5. This is what? This is 4-bit binary. Yes. So now, if I give clock pulse something like this, okay, this is now what I mean by the negative going. Yes. On what basis you say it is a negative edge triggered? If bubble is there, means it is active low, so negative edge triggered. If there is no bubble, it is a positive edge triggered. Okay. So for the very first clock going negative, okay, I got the clock input, okay, and since T is always connected or freeze to logic 1, my output previous was 0, it becomes 1. Okay, for the second negative edge of the count, T is still 0, so that's why it goes again to 0. So it is complement. When T is 1, provided clock, the next state will be complement of previous. So previous was 0, it becomes 1. For the second clock, when it is going negative, the next state will be the complement of previous. So for the next third negative clock or negative edge is coming, so what I'll say is, this will go alternate 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1. Okay. So this is what this, to that particular, where exactly the main clock is given, this becomes my least significant bit of the count. And the last cascaded one becomes the most significant bit of my count. Okay. So which is the least significant bit you have to find out? You can tell to which particular flip-flop the main count or clock is given, that will be your least significant, and the last one will be your most significant bit. Okay, now you can see that 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1 is happening, right? When this is available here, then it will be going now. Is it clear? That is what. So for one clock pulse, this is so here. When it is 0, nothing will happen. When this 1 comes here, so now this is count. Okay, next is A0. Now A0 is acting as a clock input or count for this. Is it okay? So now, this is something like this. Okay, again negative edge. Again negative edge. Okay. 0, 1, 0, 1, 0. Oh, sorry, this is 1 basically. This is 1. 01 01 01, again it will be 01, it will continue, right? So again you can see that A0 is also 01 01 01 01 01. So this next it will be, it become 1, next it will become 0, next it will become 1, next it will become 0. Once I get 1, A1, again it will be in the form of this. Again, when A1 is going negative, this is triggered. This also will go from 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1. The only reason is T input is again logic 1. Whenever this is enabled, when T is, the moment T is 1, it becomes logic 1. So this is also 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, it will come. Okay. So that I will get the flip-flop's output first, to which my main clock is connected. Next, subsequent flip-flops output, I will be getting something like this. Okay, this is what really happens in terms of 4-bit binary ripple counter. We'll see the waveforms in the next slides or so. This is using the T flip-flop. And now the same 4-bit binary counter is used in terms of D flip-flop. Yes, again you can see main clock or count is given for 1. And then you can see A0 again is going to the next clock input. A1 is going to the next clock input. A2 is going to the next clock input. Is this clear now? And parallelly, I'll be checking A0, A1, A2, A3. Okay. A0 till A3. These are my outputs. I will check at the same time all this A0, A1, A2, A3. Where again, A0 is my LSB and A3 will be my MSB. So it will be something like, whenever I see the count, it will be A3, A2, A1, and it will be A0. Something like this I will be going with. Okay. Now, this is with respect to D, I said, right? Yes. You can see that. Count is coming. D is nothing but what? This is Q bar. It is going. As I said, it is the complement output of that will be going as an input there. Okay. You can see that. For example, initially, all the flip-flops output are reset. This is, I think this is 0. Oh, I think I'm not getting here. I'll check with this. Okay, all these are 0, 0. If I consider 0, 0, 0, 0, you can see that the complement will be 1. This is 1, this is 1, this is 1, this is 1. Why? The complement outputs will be 0 because I have cleared all the flip-flops. So its complement is 1. And now the complement is acting as an 1 now. For the next clock pulse, input is 1, this will go 1. When this becomes 1, this becomes 0. And now this is acting as a 0. Okay, is it clear now? So this is how exactly it is happening now. Okay, so in order to use a D flip-flop in a ripple counter, I should ensure that the complement output of the flip-flop will go as a input for that particular flip-flop. Here also the complement output is acting as, so alternately I will be getting 0 1 0 1 0 1 0 1. Okay, so this is how exactly the 4-bit ripple counter works. Okay, so this is what the same 4-bit ripple counter. Okay, suppose the current state is 1 1 0 0, that is 12. Okay, the next state will be 13, that is 1011, binary count. So if it is down counter, it will be 11. If it is up counter, it will be 13. That is what we will have now. Okay, so that is what we try to have this. But I have to explain this particular 4-bit binary ripple counter in terms of the waveform now. That is very, very crucial now. Okay, so I'll try to see. Any space, okay. I'll try to see any space is there to explain. Okay. A register that goes through a prescribed sequence of distinct states upon the application of a sequence of input pulses is called a counter. Okay. Here, what I'll try to do now is I'll try to explain in terms of the complex with respect to the waveform. Okay. 4-bit. This is 4-bit ripple counter, or what we had called as asynchronous counter. Okay, this is very important. Make sure that this waveform is understood properly. Okay, first we add a count clock. Okay, this is what we are trying to see now. Okay, we are interested in the negative edge because active low signal. Okay, that means all the flip-flops in the T flip-flop or D flip-flop are our negative edge. Okay, first we will get A naught. Yes, because for the first flip-flop we have connected the clock or the main count. Then based on A naught I will be getting A1, and based on A1 I will be getting A2, and based on A2 I will be getting my A3. And we know that before the clock comes, all the flip-flops are initially clear, that is zero. Okay, that's what we should have now. This is what we add now. So this x-axis is with respect to my time, and y-axis is with respect to my magnitude. Okay, so this is what we have now. We'll try to analyze this now. So before the application of the first clock, so A0 I will get based on C, A1 I will get based on A0. Okay, so A0 is acting as a clock input for this. Okay, so first I'll try to analyze what is A0. Until the first clock comes, this is 0. The moment the first negative edge comes, we know that T flip-flop is connected to 1. And when T is 1, provided the clock, output is complement of the previous. Previous is 0 means now it will be 1. And it will continue to be 1 till the next clock comes. And then it goes to 0. This is what it really wants. Yes, this is what we had seen. 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1. See, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0. Absolutely. That's right. Next. Now, A0 is now acting as a clock input to C, to the next flip-flop. This is the A0 is acting as a clock input. So, again, I am interested in the negative edge of this particular A0. Not this C, this one. So until the negative edge comes, A0 will be in the previous. The moment the first negative edge comes, this goes to the complement. Yes. Until the next again complement. See, like this. Now, A1 is acting as a clock input for the next flip-flop, right? So I'm interested in this particular. So this will be 0 till the first clock comes, and then it becomes 1, and then it becomes 0. And now this A2 will be acting as a clock input for this next flip-flop. So for this is what I mean by the negative. So till the first negative edge of A2 comes, my A3 will be continuously remaining 0. Now you can see that, right? This is my LSB. This is my A3 is my MSB. Yes. You can see initially all were 0. Next, this is 1. 0, 0, 0. I am seeing only with respect to each clock pulse. Okay. This is one clock pulse. Okay. My count will be in terms of clock pulse. 0, 1. 0, 1, this is 0, this is still 0, this is 1, this is 1, this is 0, this is 0, this is 0, this is 1, this is 1, this is 0, this is 1, this is 0, this is 1, this is 0, 0, 1, 0, 1 minute, 0, 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 1, okay, I think this is the first till this point, it is going, okay, good. Okay, good, this is 0, this is 1 going, this is, okay, you can see that now, this is what LSB, this is 0. This is what? 1. What is this? 2. what is this? 3, and it keeps on going in this fashion. Okay, you can see that for count 1 I am getting 0, for count 2 I am getting 1, for count 3 it is 2, then 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, it keeps on going. Okay, what is the meaning of this now? What is the meaning of this? Meaning 4 bit, it is counting from 0 to, if I keep on increasing my clock pulses, it keeps on increasing now. Yes, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 15, and then again it becomes. Okay, so 4 bit ripple counter will have 4 flip flops. Okay, to which particular flip flop you give the main count, that will be my least significant bit. To which flip flop you give the last cascaded one, that will be my MSB. Okay, you can see now A0 with respect to this clock pulse, 2 clock cycle of C is becoming 1 clock cycle, right? And you can see that 4 clock cycle of C is becoming 1 clock cycle of this, and 8 clock cycle of this is becoming 1 clock cycle of this, and 16 clock cycle of this is becoming. So I can say that time is doubled, whereas frequency is, so this A0 output I'm calling it as divided by 2. The next is divided by 4. The next is divided by 8. And next is divided by 16. Okay. So 4 bit ripple counter is also called as divided by 2 power of 4, that is 16 bit up counting or down counting depending upon how exact, 16 bit counter. Or divided by 2 power, divided by 16 counter. What you call this as? You call this as divided by 2 power of 4 counter or divided by 16 counter. Okay. Or also you call it as a mod 16. That means you have a modulus of 16, means 0 to 15. Okay. So this is how exactly this particular counter works. And this is all about your ripple counter and how exactly we are using the T flip-flop or D flip-flop or even the JK flip-flop to be used. In the next session, we will take up the synchronous counter. And the synchronous counter, there is a common clock, as I said, that triggers all flip-flops simultaneously. I can use T or JK flip-flop. Design procedure is simple. We will try to see how exactly to be analyzing that. Okay, thank you.